Hello guys, Sanjay here and welcome to Daily Tech Bytes with Sanjay, episode number 24, where we are going to discuss about Google I/O today. And Google had released Google Duo application few days back. You must be remembering that because that was a video calling application where you can do a video call to anyone you want. And Google I/O is a messaging based application where you can send messages to anyone's numbers. And if I have to explain Google I/O to anyone, I would say when it comes to functionality, sure, functionality, it is exactly similar to WhatsApp. In WhatsApp, you can send messages to anyone in your contact, and not only that, you can create groups. In Google I/O, you can send messages to anyone and you can create groups too. There are a few other features which are available in WhatsApp which won't be available in Google I/O as of now, but those features will be available in future for sure. And Google I/O is based on mobile number, so if you want to use Google I/O application on your device, make sure that you have a phone number, which is quite obvious, because when it comes to Hangouts application, which is made by Google itself, that application can be used with only email IDs, but Google I/O requires phone number, as I said earlier too. Why am I repeating this? Anyways, now let's talk about some features which Google I/O has to offer. So the first feature is smart reply feature, where you can reply automatically. You do not have to type anything. Let's assume someone asks you, where are you? Then you can directly reply, this is my live view, by just shooting a picture. And this thing, you do not have to write live view over there. You can just tap over there and camera will open up and Google Assistant will do all those things. So that's a great feature in my opinion. After this, we have something called as stickers in Google I/O. So if you have used stickers in Hangouts or if you have used them in Facebook Messenger application, those are same over here too. And that's very interesting feature because these stickers are designed by independent artists and studios from around the world. After this, we have a feature known as shout or whisper. Let's assume you want to tell your friend that you have to come early tomorrow and you want to write it in bold. But to write it in bold in WhatsApp application, you have to write star before and after each word, which is quite hectic. But in Google I/O, you just have to swipe up, then all the characters will become all caps. Not only this, the size of the characters will increase. But if you want to whisper anything and you want to write it quietly, then swipe down and everything will become small, as you can see on the screen right now. After this, we have something called as ink. So if you have used Snapchat anytime, then you must be knowing about this feature that you can doodle anything on the photos or you can add text on the photos. You cannot rotate them as of September 2016, but that feature must be coming in the future. Incognito mode is also present in Google I/O application, which will auto delete the chats after a particular time. So currently it is set to 1 hour, but you can change that time to anything that you want, which is a good thing in my opinion. And not only this, but all the incognito chats will be end to end encrypted, so you do not have to worry if someone will spy on your incognito chats. That's not going to be possible. And the last and the best feature that Google I/O has to offer has to be the Google Assistant. And Google Assistant is so much fun. As you can see in the video right now, you can ask her any question. I don't know if it is her or him, but I would like to prefer her. So if you ask her what's the time, she'll tell you the time. If you ask her what are the latest Bollywood movies, she'll tell you the latest Bollywood movies. If you ask her what are the latest Marvel movies, she'll tell you the Marvel movies. If you ask her to wake you up at 8:30, she'll do that for you too. If you ask her to remind something to you, she'll do that too, which is a great thing in my opinion. And this feature is once again similar to Hike application, if you have heard about that. So it's time for my final opinion. So you must have heard while describing all these features, I said that you must have used this feature in Snapchat, you must have used this feature in Hike, this was similar to WhatsApp, this was similar to Instagram, because obviously Google has taken all the best features in all these applications and merged them into Google I/O. But I won't say that Google I/O is the best application that you can use right now, because there are no privacy settings, the normal chats that we are going to do are not going to be end-to-end encrypted, no themes, no customization option, and there are multiple other things which are missing in Google I/O. So it is not the best application right now, but in future it can be a best application. But Google will surely work hard on Google I/O application, and I do not understand why Google wants to make so many different applications such as Google I/O, Google Duo, Google Hangouts. You can merge all these three applications into one application, which can be the best application that you have, and you can just keep updating that application, maybe something like that. Google, come on, you can do that, right? So yeah, that was pretty much it for Google I/O application. And if you want to try it out, I'll give the link of that in the description box below, so do not worry about that. After this, now let's talk about the tech news which are going around in the world. So we have three tech news. First, Lyco Pro 3 was launched, which has Snapdragon 821 processor, 4GB and 6GB RAM variant, 5.5 inch full HD display and 4GB RAM variant will cost around 18,000 to 20,000 Indian rupees. So that's quite cheap in my opinion. Finally, Xiaomi Mi Band 2 was released in India with Xiaomi Mi Purifier 2. So you can buy the Mi Band 2 for 2,000 rupees and you can buy the Mi Purifier 2 if you want to for 10,000 rupees. When is Mi Band 2 coming in India? Was the most asked question to me. And finally, Mi Band 2 has released. So if you want to buy Mi Band 2, you can go ahead and do that. I'll give the link of that in the description box below. And the final news is that the Google Pixel phones will be having IP53 certifications, or most likely will be having IP53 certification, which means the device won't be water resistant completely. But if you use the device in light rain, then it will not harm your device. So that's a good thing. And I'm waiting for Pixel XL phone. After the tech news, now let's talk about our tech deal. So today I have very interesting tech deal and it is on router. So the first router that we have over here, TP-Link TLWR841N. I used this router personally and it's an amazing router. If you have budget of 1000 rupees, you have to go with this one. And I have used this TP-Link 150 Mbps wireless adapter too. So if you want to buy any router, then you can go ahead and do that. TP-Link and D-Link routers are the best routers you can buy in my opinion in budget price range. So yeah, this was pretty much it for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video, and let's see if we can reach 500 likes on this video. And if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, then don't forget to hit that subscribe button over there. And if you want to watch more content, you can watch that over here. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.